The Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1729, Hyperlink to a Hidden Sheet. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Today's question sent in by Shanna. Shanna has a dashboard report. She has a menu with 50 hyperlinks and then 50 worksheets back here, and wants to be able to link from the hyperlink to the worksheet. But here's the thing. The 50 sheets are hidden. How can you hyperlink to a hidden sheet? Well, first, let's set up a hyperlink here. So I'm going to do Ctrl+K. We're going to link to a place in this document. It's going to be part 5, cell A1. Click OK. And then on each of the sheets, I imagine there's a hyperlink that goes back, to the menu cell A1. So that way you can jump to a sheet, jump back. All right, but right now everything is visible. Shanna has everything hidden. So home, format, hide and unhide, hide sheet, those are all hidden. And now these hyperlinks are not going to work because there's nothing to go to, right? Very, very frustrating. Well, what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to use a little bit of VBA in order to unhide the sheet. So when they click on the hyperlink, we're going to unhide the sheet and then let the hyperlink work. So here's what you do. You go to Alt F11. If you don't see the Project Explorer, View, Project Explorer, or Control R. And we want to go to Sheet 1. We're going to double click Sheet 1 to get to the code pane for that sheet. This isn't a regular macro that's written on a module like this one down here. It's written on the actual sheet's code pane. Top left drop down, there's only one thing to choose, that's worksheet. And then they always choose selection change by default. We'll get rid of that. Go to the top right hand drop down, and there is an event for follow hyperlink. Follow hyperlink. Okay, now for those of you that are kind of new to VBA, or even those of you who have been around for VBA for a while, you know, sometimes you don't remember all of the properties that are available for a hyperlink. So right here, they've given us a variable called target as hyperlink, and I can't remember what exactly I need. So x equals target dot, all right, and they're offering me address. Well, maybe address is what I want, but I want to see. I want to see what happens. So debug dot print x, all right, just to see what's there. And then the most important part, I'm going to stop, so that way the macro goes into debug mode while this variable is still valid, alive. So now we'll come back here, we'll click, and that actually, see, that runs that macro. We press Control G to see. Look at that. So there was nothing in the address. All right, so this is where we're going to use a cool feature called the object, the watch window. I'm going to take the word target, I'm going to right click on target and say that I want to add a watch, and I want to watch the expression called target. All right, and what we get here is a watch where we can see the address is in fact blank, but I can now browse through here and see that income, that was the word that we clicked on. Right here, this is it. I'm looking for the sheet name and where we're going, and that's in something called sub address. All right, so by using the watch window, I was able to figure out that I'm looking for dot sub address instead of dot address. All right, so the watch window is very handy when, you know, something goes wrong here, like where we couldn't figure out where to go. All right, so at this point, I'll stop this code. I remember that it's sub address and not address, and I'm actually going to pop in some code that I wrote beforehand. Okay, so I'm going to set up a variable called linkTo. linkTo is the target.subaddress, so that's going to be sheet name exclamation point, which geek programmers call the bang. All right, and I guess I'm a geek programmer because my next variable is called where bang. Where's the bang? Do the int string starting in position 1 of the linkTo, looking for the exclamation point, and that'll tell me where it starts. If it's not found, I'll get a 0. So if where bang is greater than 0, then I figure out another variable called mySheet. It's the left of linkTo up to the where bang position minus 1. And we will then make worksheets that sheet visible. Equals true, select that sheet. All right, so now we've gone to that sheet. And I have to tell you, the first time I wrote this for Shanna, I stopped at this point because I figured that the macro would end and it would go ahead and follow the hyperlink. But it doesn't. When you have this event, it doesn't follow the hyperlink. It just comes here and runs this macro. So now, me, as the writer of the macro, is responsible for actually doing the hyperlink. Very annoying. that I had to do that, but hey, you know, it took a few minutes and we're good to go. So we actually select the sheet, and then I had to figure out where the address was. So that's the mid of link 2, starting at where bang plus 1. I don't have to specify how many characters, because here in VBA, the mid will just go to the end. And then this was driving me nuts. This was the original code that I had here, and it would not work. It kept giving me an error saying that it was invalid, and I'd hover over my address. Well, hey, tell you what, let's run it. I'll show you what was happening to me. So I'd click on income. See, income is not visible right now. I click on income, and sure enough, it becomes visible back there, but I get this error that's saying that my address A1 is not valid, and I'm like, what? How can that not be valid? I wrote a new little macro and tested, and sure enough, it works. Why isn't this working? I was ready to head out to the Mr. Excel message board, where the smartest VBA programmers in the planet hang out, to ask them why I'm just so stupid today. And then I realized, oh, wait a second, this isn't running in a module. This is running on a sheet called menu, and the sheet called menu doesn't know anything about a cell called A1 out on a worksheet called part 1. So this line of code had to go, and I had to fully qualify. So worksheets, my sheet, range, my address. This is like, this is a foreign concept to the macro running on sheet 1. If we're going to talk about a range on another sheet, we have to fully qualify it, and we'll let that run, and that will solve the problem. Okay, so we're here on menu. Actually, here, I'm going to reveal that in a second. We're here on menu. I click on expense. And it unhides part 2 and takes me to that page, follows the hyperlink. To make the back work, I figured that when they clicked back, we need to hide the current sheet. And so here, let's take a look. I double click on part 1. Again, the follow hyperlink. And I just hard coded, hey, we're always going back to menu. And then I wanted to take whatever sheet the target lived on. So the target remembers the hyperlink that we clicked on. That's the word back. If we go to dot parent, dot worksheet, that will say the parent is where the hyperlink is living. The word back is living on the sheet called part 1. That worksheet.visible is equal to false. And once that code is working, I had to control C that, and then double click on every sheet that I might potentially be going to, and control V to paste. Now, Shanna has 50 of these. What a pain to have to go through and do that. But you know, once you do it once, then everything will be working just perfectly. You click on the hyperlink, it unhides the sheet. When they click back, it will hide the sheet. So very interesting. I'd love to see this dashboard that she has with 50 different sheets. It probably will be a cool hit at her company. All right, well, hey, I want to thank Shanna for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. I covered a couple of different things there, how to follow hyperlinks to hidden sheets, and also how to use the watch window to discover which property has the value that you're looking for. A great way to browse to figure out which property to use. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.